Let's create one more exercise in Autodesk Fusion. So in this video, you'll learn to use the extrude, hole, create an offset plane and create a plane along a path and fill it. So open the Fusion and let's go. The first step to create this part, we'll make the base. So the base is a circle with 128 millimeters of diameter, and we need to extrude this 15 millimeters. So open the Fusion, go to create a sketch and select the front plane, select the circle, make a circle here with 128 millimeters, finish the sketch, go to extrude, select this profile, 15 millimeters of distance and press OK. Now we will create this hole. So we have 3 points here. And the distance between the center of this point and the midpoint is 40 millimeters. And here 40 millimeters. And the distance here 35 millimeters. So let's create this 2 point. So go to create a sketch, select this face, select a line, and select a construction line type, make this sketch here, go to sketch dimension, the distance here 40 millimeters, and the distance here 40 millimeters, and the distance here is 35 millimeters, and this point here 35 millimeters, and it is vertical with this point here. Now go to create and select a point, make a point here. We have this 3 point, so finish the sketch, go to hole, and this hole has 40 millimeters and 8 millimeters here, and this diameter is 9 millimeters. So the placement from the sketch, select this point, and this point. The hole type, select the contour body. The extent, select the all. The diameter here, 14 millimeters of diameter. The distance here, 8. And the diameter here is 90 millimeters of diameter. And press OK. Now we will create a new plane to make this cylinder here. So we needed to create this line here and this one. So this plane must be 5.9 millimeters of distance from the front plane. So let's create this plane. Go to construct, select offset plane. Select this plane here, 5.9, and press OK. And now we will create this line here. And this one, this line here is perpendicular with this one. And the angle between this line and the base is 37 degrees. And this point here is horizontal with the midpoint. So go to create a sketch, select this new plane. And press letter P in the keyboard, selection filter body. Select this body and press OK. Now select line, a construction line, and make a line here, body, and make another line here. Go to constraint, select perpendicular, select these two line, and go to sketch dimension. The angle here, 37 degrees, and go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this point and the midpoint here, and the distance between this point and the bottom face here is 43 millimeters. So go to sketch dimension. The distance here, 43 millimeters, and press OK. Finish the sketch. And now we will create a plane here at this point. So go to construct, select the plane along path, select the, remove the tangent chain, and select this line here. Look at the distance here. The direction is this one, so we'll use the distance 0 and press OK. hide the sketch tree, and go to create a sketch, select this new plane. In this new plane, we will create a circle with 87 millimeters of diameter and extrude this to this face. So select the circle, find the center here, 87 millimeters of diameter. Finish the sketch, go to extrude. The extended type, select to object. The object, select this face. And operation join, press OK. Now we'll make some cuts in the cylinder. And the first cut that we'll make a circle here with 119 millimeters of diameter to make this cut here. So go to create a sketch, select this face, select a circle, click here in this point, make a circle here with 119 millimeters, and create another circle here with 118 millimeters. And finish the sketch, go to extrude, select this profile. Let me hide this body a little bit. Make sure that you have selected this profile. And the operation here is cut the distance, all cut. Make sure that is the same direction here and press OK. Now we will make this cut. Look this. So to create this, we'll make a rectangle here. And the distance between this line here and this tangent point here will be 44 millimeters. So go to create a sketch, select this face, select a rectangle, center rectangle, make a rectangle here. I will move this a little bit. Go to constraints, horizontal, vertical, select this point and this point here. And go to sketch dimension, click with the right button here and select peak circle arc tangent, select this arc and select this line here. The distance here is 44 millimeters. We'll put some dimension here and finish the sketch, go to extrude, select this rectangle. And the distance here is all, operation cut, and press OK. And now, we will make this cut here, in this cylinder. Let me erase this. We will remove this area here. So, we will select this face to make a sketch, and we will create this line here. And remove this area. The distance between this point here and the center point is 15 millimeters, and this point here is horizontal vertical with the center point. So go to create a sketch and select the circle, press letter P in the keyboard, and selection filter, select specified entities, select this face and press OK. Now select line, make a line between this line here and this circle. And go to sketch dimension, the distance here, 15 millimeters. And go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this point and this point here, the center of this circle. And finish the sketch and go to extrude, select this profile. And the extend here, select it to object and select this face. The operation here is cut and press OK. Now we will create this part here. So to create this, we will select this face to make a sketch and we'll make this sketch here. So go to create a sketch, select this face, Press letter P in the keyboard, select this face and press OK. Select line, a construction line, make a construction line here. It will be used for reference. And remove the construction line type. We'll make this sketch, a line here. The distance between this point and the center point here, 52 millimeters. A line here, this line has 45 millimeters. And we will create this line here. And the angle between this line and this line here, this construction line, is 55 degrees. So select the line, click here in this point. Make sure that this three line is perpendicular each other. And go to sketch dimension. The distance between this line here and this point is 52 millimeters. The angle here is 55 degrees. And the length here is 45 millimeters. And finish the sketch. We needed to extrude this 25 millimeters, and we have an offset with 5 millimeters of distance. Look at this sketch here, 5 millimeters and 25. So go to extrude, select this profile, and this start, select the offset, the distance here, 5 millimeters. But in this case, we use minus 5 to change the direction. And the distance here, minus 25 millimeters. Operation join and press OK. And here, we have a fillet in the corners. The fillet here is 5 millimeters of radius. So go to fillet, select this edge here. 5 millimeters, and press OK. And now to finish this, we'll make this hole here in the center of this face. So we have a hole with 40 millimeters of diameter by 30. And we have another cut here with 45 millimeters of diameter through this body. So let's create this. So go to create a sketch and select this circle. Press letter P in the keyboard. Select this face and press OK. Select the circle. Find the center of this arc. Make a circle here with 40 millimeters of diameter. And another circle with 45 millimeters of diameter. And finish the sketch. Go to extrude. Select only the circle with 40 millimeters of diameter. The extrusion here is minus 30 millimeters. Operation cut and press OK. And show the sketch 9 again. Go to extrude, select the circle with 40 millimeters and the circle with 45 millimeters. And the direction one side, they start, select the offset. The offset here, minus 30 millimeters. The distance all, and flip the direction, and press OK. Let me show for you. Hide the sketch 9. And that's it. So let's check the volume of this part. Go to property. And it is the correct answer. So here we finish our exercise. Thanks for watching. Subscribe my channel for more, and see you in the next videos. Bye bye.